Hey everybody. Here's Joey Real Time.
Just mute some of the noise that's going on here.
Alright. So we've 600 plus TV down. I don't know what it is. We have Deep Root. We have Zara, of course. We have, who else do we have? I assume there's a Master Chef. It looks like he's stolen one of the rerolls, so the Chorps have to work with a single reroll. And this is going to be a game of attrition. But you're thinking Halflings are going to take the damage from the Chorps. Yeah, maybe. Halflings will take damage from any team. It's the Dwarves who are going to have to watch out for the attrition from the three trees, which have Mighty Blow and, of course, the two trees that are officially with the team, Avgard. Let's see what we've got here. Giant Enderpoos and Hue Fungus. So, yeah, might be up to these bulls to run the ball as quickly as they can. If that were a removal, turn one, this could have been very exciting. And there goes the first halfling. That was a mistake, right there. But we'll learn it sometimes. Obviously a risk he was willing to take. I'm just gonna... one moment, if you will, team. Okay. And pulls his bull back. Even takes a GFI to keep him safe. I don't know what he was worrying about, but... I guess he just didn't want the tree marking up the bull. Easy pick up on the ball. So, question is, what is the tree strategy going to be here? Takes his first stun. He does have Zara. Thank you. hitting the Hobgoblin is probably a good idea. Could 3D blitz it. There we go, KO. Linen vs game. Thank you for the follow and welcome to the crew. Still gets to take another crack at the chalk there. Send a bit of light pressure around the side of the pitch. I think in the chalks will want to get moving as quickly as possible. Power on the chalk. That guard presence really will make a big difference. Doesn't blitz with the Mighty Blow piling on. So if you're switching sides. If I blitz, it's a push. Another GFI to complete the cage. Still a long way to go for the chores. The tree is a single GFI to marking the ball. Usually Lonroll has enjoyed the fruits of other teams' deep reroll pulls, but the Chorfs only have a single or two rerolls. Of course, stripping the Chorfs of their two rerolls is a huge boon, but only getting one or two in reply, limits him a little bit. Especially when he's facing guys with so much block. Three D pays off. So I can free up Zara. Keep her in a better spot. And takes the power with Zara. And follows, interesting. Not seeing any fouling. That then he's a little bit pressed for coverage. Oh, here we go. 3D time. It's just strength 7P, so. And he gets a hit on the killer. No removal back. Pins the ball. So he can't get a 2D or even a 1D on the ball. He could red dice the tree. Tree has stand firm and block though. Likely we'll see a dodge. He could have attempted a handoff to the ball, but now the ball's been marked. It's a 5 plus. Nope, he finds a power. A handoff now. Handoff is a 4 plus with 50-50. One reroll. But if he gets it, he's away. He's done. He's got the touchdown. More than likely. Shy of like a red die sacking of the ball. Alright, we're gonna do a dodge. Which is a 3 plus. And the tree can still reach to mark the double GFI. Now we can't. So what Lonro really needs to see is some damage done to these chores, get them off the pitch. He needs his mighty blow to come in. He's taking the hits. Ooh, how about it's pal? That's done. Fishing for some skulls. Some ones. puts a double GFI for the ball. He could even actually surf with the ball if he can get off that halfling. The halfling could dodge away and scream as well. He has a deep bench of halflings though, so. No break tackle on the ball. So likely a punch from the ball. And he could blitz the hobgoblin and run him up further. And full potato. How's he follow? Been in Rome. Best injury. Just an MNG. Alright, he's just gonna get into a punching match. Decides to mark up Zara. She has got dodge. Armor break. Wow. Wow. Ball's in trouble now. Ball is in big trouble. He can mark here. He can blitz 2D on the ball. And then he's still got these two guys to play with. Should it scatter into the crowd? Nice. One tree wrapped up. I mean, one, three chorfs on one tree there. Keeps the ball busy. Chorf to worry about. Yep, so there's the ball. That's the anti-assist. Is it safety? One, two, three, four, five. He's added in a GFI. To Zara. Oh, he's just taking the hit on the ball. This could be bad armor break. Nope, it's fine. Alright. I'm taking a 1D blitz on the ball carrier. Didn't want to take the dodge, just going for the safer option in terms of, yeah, just take the push. Okay, he's pinning him in. So Zara may take a hit here. Only if he blitzes with him. So stand everybody up. Oh no, no, I didn't see he got the anti-assist to the hobgoblin. Surfing the halfling here. Yeah, I wouldn't have kicked him on the sideline. So now he can just punch the halfling. Ball's free. I think the Zara dodge was the better play. Get 2D block on the ball. The hobgoblin's got nothing but sure hands. Another one down. Well, if he does potato with the hobgoblin, then it will be a Zara dodge blitz. 3 plus with reroll. 2D. Where is safe? Where is safe? Apparently, planting a potato in the field is the safe. Oh, here goes the reroll. Blew it on a GFI. So now Zara has to GFI. And she's a loner. In which case, it would probably be best to take the hits first. Ooh, goes for the dwarf dodge. Oh! No more dodging for the jaw. He's out. Sticking. Oh yeah, Bose. Want some A for the next game and B so that he can hit halflings with them next time. And oh yeah, he has a bench. You know, yeah. I mean, it's hobgoblins, but he has a bench. Might have been worth saving that apo. Trees can be brutal. Alright, Zara dodge. Takes his tree hits first. He's walking the guy to the edge. Well, that take root and the skull power, that was a 1 and a 2. Uh-oh. Alright, she's away. Hit some power. Ooh, oh, KO. There goes the ball carrier. Good night. He's still got my balls on the ground. Could GFI with Zara? Probably not worth it. He's got the bulls mostly tied up. The bull could take a 2D on Zara and try to pick up the ball. 1D on Zara and try to pick up the ball. Oh, if he can dodge the tree. Oh, GFI. No, he's going straight. I might have tried GFIing the tree onto the bull. Yeah, if you could have marked the ball with the tree, then he could have potentially dodged the halfling away. Oh, he's gone for it. He's got the two rerolls. Oh, interesting. Could have also picked up the ball and handed it off to Zara. Alright, here we go. Here's the blitz. He does not want to give up the fight. Oh, he blitzed on a frenzy. So he's not going anywhere. Have to follow. Still got the... Wow, he doesn't need a break tackle because he's got the... He freed up the ball. Of course, between the Zara and the halfling, he can knock the ball off, pick up the ball and take over with it. Zara's blodge, so there's no tackle anywhere nearby. Chuff dodge. One of these will fail sooner or later. Like five chuffs tied up over three trees. It were. Punch on the ball. Whoa, whoa. Oh, he's going for the hobgoblin. No break. She's gonna dodge. Ooh, another turn and he's in the crowd. Two chores in the crowd next turn. Those armor rolls, you may not see him back from. So, yeah. Second injury for the halflings. Still got a bench of two. With two KOs, it means he's still at a full 11. In the second half. Hey, he gets his pow.
Now he can take a... He can build a 2D on Zara.
Oh, he's going to...
He's still going to take the 2D on Zara, I'd say.
Oh, he's going for the 3D on the Halfling.
Ooh.
Jack Hoff is stunned.
So next turn, Zara's all on her own here. If he could get, or could have got his hands on the actual ball. Alright, save himself one surf. Didn't move his Mighty Blow Chwarf piece up before taking those dodges.
Alright, armor. Nothing. He's safe. Gets a 3 on the injury.
Nice. Yeah, having as many players up there as possible is going to make it hard should the pickup fail. So we might see a dodge blitz.
Here it is. Ooh, gets the pal. Beautiful. So now he can just slot himself. And a break. So he puts himself in here, yep. So now he's at a 1D blitz. No reroll on a bludge piece. Just needs a push, and the hobgoblin can swoop in. And score with a GFI. 3 plus, 2 plus. I'd say that that's going to be the play. And if he had moved this piece up 4 squares, he would have been in a range to bring in an assist. Gets the push he needs. Oh, and there's the one. So first half, drive failed for the Chorfs. The chef coming into play there, stealing that reroll. Good old Halfling Master Chef. So Hobgoblin's going to take a hit here. He can even take a... They can take a follow-up hit too. Scatters the ball. Gets the pal. No break. Foul, maybe? Got a nice deep bench. 5 on the bench. Goes for the pass. Gets inaccurate. Rerolls. Should have dodged first. He would have got it if he dodged. Heroes come back. And one of the hobos. So Chorf's only down the one where they were. Okay, no rerolls. For the Chorfs. But they have a full team. Oh, I see what happened there. Keeping a nice wide spread. Ready to respond to a kickoff. Putting his sacrificial hobgoblins on the line. So he's got Zara and the tree still to field here. Here we go. The match is certainly flying by. Not a lot of indecision from the coaches. Ah, Chorfs get thrown a bone. One reroll. Let's see how quickly it takes them to burn through that. Push from the first tree. This hobo won't survive. Yeah, shame we didn't see more fouling in the first half. Especially now that there's, you know, there's still a bench of two halflings. But perhaps some greater strategy there from Lonro, the master halfling coach. You think, you know, everyone's pretty happy if the halflings can knock the Chorfs out of the game. But really, maybe the entire season we should have been looking for these halflings to get knocked out somewhere, because they've been dominating the matches. Question is it a low and slow defense, or is it an aggressive attack on ball? Because if he knocks this halfling out of the way here with a break tackle, dodge through the corner, he can mark Zara with a triple GFI. probably not too keen to risk his balls. Not really much he wants to do. He's declawed the trees for the time being, but it has allowed them to just control the pitch. Probably hoping for a few take roots. Ooh, we're gonna see a foul. Four assists? No. Nice and conservative. Hold on to as many pieces as he can for as long as possible. Chorfs really need to do some damage. It's the Chorfs game to lose, because either way, if it's a draw at the end of turn 20, whatever, three rerolls on Lomro, one on Belwin. If it's a kickoff, odds are favourite on Lomro with more rerolls. In fact, it's a shame he even had to burn one if he had just kept on holding all four. Really, really cheap way to win. But, and again, blitzing without tackle. And it wasn't even a three die. He could have added a single assist to make that a three die if he wanted to farm on the ball. A three die with frenzy, then it's six dies. Would have been even better. So I'm not sure what the thought process was there. But no doubt we're going to see the trees start to come forward now.
Ha!
It's a pal, no removal. It's got two halflings semi-tied up. Scary part will be in actually committing these trees. But, I'm gonna blitz the guard. Now he can insert his tree with guard up against this dwarf here. Bring in an extra halfling for a 2D, and then put the downed halfling on the end of the line for another 2D on the other chore. So he's just pushing and pushing and pushing him back. Pal, oh, he's stuck on the trees now. So probably the weakness of this Chorf team in their development is that they just don't have the guard. So that a team of three trees and then a score of two strength halflings can actually push them around. Bonk. Still no break. What's worse is that the Chorf just can't pressure the halflings to force mistakes. He's still on three rerolls. And again, worst case scenario, nobody scores. And it goes to a kickoff. And at that point, Lonro wins. You know, statistically. So yeah, is he gonna send in, is it the halfling hit? It's the halfling hit.
follows it up. Yeah, he can slap his guard in there. Or we can blitz in with tree root. Deep root. Strong branch. Which means he can insert his guard on the left side. Ooh, gets a bonk. That's unfortunate. Ooh, he rolls that. Can't have his tree taking root right now. We've seen some major pressure applied here. He's really forcing Belwyn's hand in the next turn. The inclination would be to apply himself, his line to the weaker halfling line, which could pay off. But if he does that, he could leave himself open to the ball, you know, changing directions or whatever. Seeing a very conservative defense here. He's just continuing to create his line. Okay, he's going directly for the ball. Follows it up. Double push. So Zara's still able to free herself from that. Potentially lock that ball out of the future play. Let's push. So, how can he leverage all of this pressure to his advantage? If you haven't noticed, between the Chorfs and the bull, if he moves this bull into here, he's just cut 80% of the team off from the rest of the pitch. Knocks him onto strong arm. It's probably a smart move. Bit too much strength for the tree to hold on his own here. So Zara can blitz and move out this way and bring the halflings over. There's the cow. Oh, gets it with the halfling, so he doesn't even need the blitz. Does she stay here? Or does she go? The only other problem is that the halflings is going to go for the extra hit. No. Oh, yep. He's making a nice little secondary cage over here. He's got one more free halfling and then two that can dodge. One that can dodge safely over here. He can even put it in here and take an extra hit. Doesn't need to, though. Very quick game. Coming up to 58 minutes. 59 minutes. So these guys are flying through their turns. They know exactly what they want to do. Really see Belwyn just though creating that defense, keeping that line solid, just puzzled at how to break the strength of the line. There may have been a few turns in there where he could have just thrown some red dye. Against the trees, that is. Oh, baby, dub skulls. There goes his reroll. He must have really wanted to free up this hobgoblin for him to blow that reroll. Wasn't a second thought. Maybe he should have taken the second to think about it, but there we go. Risky GFI. And one final hit. Still got the frenzy bull. So he can follow this, but he gets him stuck on a tree. Yeah, I'd say this last two turns have made it tight. The halflings were in complete control of their drive, shy of breaking the line that is. And now Zara is in a little bit of a pickle. Oh, block. He was making an escape there. So, I mean, worst case scenario, Zara blitzes and just runs out to the right. Chicken potato. She takes two GFIs, she can be a pain in the ass. Yep, here we go. This what you want. Follows, ooh. Just gonna dodge away. And nice break for it. Now, does she GFI? We can still red die her. I wouldn't take the GFI. Still got a halfling to work with. Took a GFI. What a boss. He's still got the reroll. It's on a loner though, so. But to get a one die, he needs to take a lot of three. He needs two GFIs to get a 1D with no block. Oh, there it is. Yeah, she's safe. No reroll. Red die. Needs a double six. Pretty unlikely. And I guess, yeah, that's how you beat Chorfs with Halflings. A lot of TV down. Just a lot of petty cash. All the star players. Take his free hits. And with that KO, that's game. That is game, set, and match. Shy of a Riot. Turn 16 Riot in an amazing pass play from some hoppers, some balls or something. Takes the win, doesn't even second guess it. Only two injuries for the halflings. Just really took no damage. Here's a turn for the Chorfs. Chorfs got a flight. Considering. Yeah, flings. Flings with a semi. Nicely put, Lima. Thank you.
So we sit up in the event of a, what do you call it? A riot. Or a blitz. A riot or a blitz could do it for him. Trees are, well, halflings are looking to avoid damage. Which isn't a dumb move. But a riot or a blitz could, could see the game drawn. Unlikely, but possible. This is Blood Bowl. Sorry, I keep saying blitz, but I don't mean blitz. Right, just a right. Never mind then. Oh, it was a perfect D, wasn't it? I wasn't watching. There it is. Oh, I was going to say MVP, but it doesn't matter. Very low armor break game for a Chorf match. 40 blocks, 30s6. Yeah, just not a lot of damage. 4 goes SPP for his team. gets the MVP in later, at least. Yeah, just not really much to speak of, you know? It was just a very straightforward slow drive up each side. And that's that. So, yeah. Good game, guys. And congratulations to the Halflings, who will continue on. Let's have a look here. To the Show Pony Cup. Leaderboard,
they're not on it yet, but obviously the Norse, the Skaven, and the Halflings move to the top. Dark Elf and Necro is listed as a draw. That was from the kickoff. So I don't understand how that works. I thought that the Dark Elves beat the Necros in terms of, you know, they won the kickoff, the kicking event. And then if... Snappy Dresses, Elven, the Dwarfs, Elven Union, Black Crows, and obviously the Chorfs now sitting at the bottom of the leaderboard, so yeah. I don't know how it all works. I'm not an expert on the OBBL, but we'll figure it all out soon. So yeah, I will leave it at that. I'm going to bring down the stream and I'll come back to play my own games.